Visiting with Huell Howser is made possible through a generous grant from the Ralph M. Parsons Foundation.
Well, hello, everybody. I'm Huell Howser, and this is going to be one of those, I'm not sure how this is going to turn out because this is totally unrehearsed. Buddy, you invited me to come to this class. You are the instructor. Let's set the stage. Exactly where are we physically right now?
We are at the Hollywood Senior Multipurpose Center, which is in conjunction with the Hollywood Assistance League of California.
We're right off Sunset Boulevard, close to KCET.
Right.
You sent me an email, I think, a couple of months ago.
Yeah,
you've been bugging me to come to this class for a long time.
And you came,
What exactly are we going to be a part of today? Because this is very interesting.
We are a group of older adults who are pursuing commercial acting. LA Unified has a program designed for older adults through Hollywood Community Adult School that provides the fundamentals needed to get out there and get work and get money through commercial acting.
In commercials.
Yeah, TV commercials.
Now, we just got here. I haven't met any of these people. We will be talking with a lot of them today. Are most of these people pure amateurs? Have they ever been in showbiz before?
Everybody is interested. Everybody.
They don't have careers. They didn't have careers.
No, they didn't come into the class with careers.
Right.
They found careers, they discovered careers, and about a quarter of them are going out on auditions weekly.
Really?
Yeah.
And do they come in here with great expectations of being discovered?
Mm.
Or is this just something kind of fun for them to do?
I think people in Hollywood understand the reality that this is not an easy business. But they also know that they're unique because they're older. They're mature. They're different than everybody else on the street. And there's a place for older adults in commercials.
And how long is the class? Is it weeks long, months long?
It runs semesters. It runs fall and spring semesters.
Uh-huh.
Right.
And you start them from scratch.
Right.
They've
we start with
the
history.
Never been in front of a camera
we
before.
We start with, what do you remember? What is your first commercial that you remember? Mm-hmm. Do you remember Milton Berle selling Texaco?
Uh-huh.
Do you remember Bob Hope selling blah, blah?
Uh-huh.
And then we go on from there. Why do they want to bring in real people to show real people using the product?
Yeah.
Because we identify with real people.
So that's where the secret is in their minds, that they can be discovered at their age as real people.
That's what they
selling
are.
Selling a product.
Yeah,
being
that's what they
in
are.
A commercial.
Yeah, that's what they are. Real people taking Anacin. Real people driving a Ford.
And you don't raise their expectations beyond what is practical, do you?
I explain to them that it's a business and that there's a lot of competition and that they're all unique.
Yeah.
And they have something to offer.
Well, let's dive in. What's going to happen right now?
We're working on an exercise now for a storage units situation where a family has sent their children off and their children are moving home again and they have to deal with all their belongings.
So you give them a script. Now,
yeah,
are they
yeah.
playing off one script? And here's the little
right.
camera that
right.
they're going to be sitting in
right.
front of.
We videotape them.
Uh-huh.
Each of them doing the same script. They've been given direction. They understand the character. They understand the motivation. They understand the purpose of the commercial.
They all have the same
right.
commercial.
Right.
Let me talk to this lady right here. You're rehearsing.
Yes.
Now, did you see this before today?
Not before today.
So,
actually, I saw it last semester.
It's an old script. Oh, you're a second semester student. Excuse me. Have you got it down?
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
so
trying.
We're going to get you reading into the camera.
Oh, you are.
Are you excited about this class?
Yes. I've learned a lot in this class.
What have you learned?
Well, I never did commercials before, so I learned on-camera techniques,
mm-hmm.
Co-reading, how to put the product out, you know,
uh-huh.
make sure that if you're doing a commercial and you're doing it about a product, that you let the audience know that product is...
And what has it done for your self-confidence just as a person?
Well, as a person, it's really good to my self-confidence to be able to get up in front of people.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have stage fright anymore.
Uh-huh.
I'm not nervous.
You used to be.
Oh, yes. I used to be so afraid to talk in front of people that my mouth would shake and tremble so that
well,
I couldn't.
Well, now you're talking in front of thousands of people.
Well, I can do it now. That's what Buddy's taught me.
You know, you're good. Maybe I should be your agent. We could go places
I would like
together.
That. I would love it.
Remember, I get 15%.
15? I thought it was 10.
They know better.
Oh, you told him it's only 10.
Only 10. Don't go ahead.
But you can still be my agent.
Well, let me talk to this lady for a minute, too.
All right.
Come on over here, because I might want to be your agent, too.
Ah, yes.
Shirley, why don't you tell him how old you are?
What?
Tell him how old you are.
2 and a half.
How old are you?
Well, I'm 95.
Really? And is this your first commercial acting class?
Well, let's see. Yes, I'd say yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, my first.
And what made you come sign up?
Well, I had a talent for this. I thought I'd like to try it out with just plain curiosity, see what it was all about.
Uh-huh. And how do you think it's going?
Like, it fascinates me.
Mm-hmm.
I find it fascinating.
Do you think, is there a particular product that you think you would be good selling? What would be the best product for you to sell?
Well, let's see, dramatic acting or trying to act funny or being, I would think not making a damn fool out of myself. Let's see.
But I mean, maybe cars or
what's
cereal
a
or
that you think you
a product that you could
sell.
You
could sell both flowers.
Flowers?
I guess, I'm just guessing this.
Well,
flowers,
that would
just
be great. That makes sense because sure. It helps if you're selling something you really love.
Yes, yes. I would buy flowers from her.
Yeah, you would.
Is she a pretty good student?
She's wonderful. She's wonderful. We find that the less experienced people are the most natural people who come across as being real and genuine because there's no pretense.
When you say less experienced, you're talking only in front of the camera. She's had 95 years of experience of living life.
Exactly.
My mother took me to a lot of picture shows, and I was a great reader, and all of a sudden I had a crazy idea. They wanted me to improve that. I said, I think I'll read all these great books like the Bible and Shakespeare, but I find out it hasn't changed me one bit. It hasn't changed my nature.
Really?
Yeah, come in contact with all these great writers and all that, but I'm still the same somehow.
You've got a good heart.
Oh, yeah, I got a good heart.
You know who you are.
Yes, I have a good heart. I take sitting up exercise every day, so that's what makes my good heart.
See, she could do a commercial for a gym, for a health center.
Sure.
There are all kinds of things. Geritol.
How you is my director. You can direct me.
Well, I think we should get started.
Okay.
I don't know. I mean, let's see what are we doing? Excuse me, just a minute. Are you giving advice? Are you all trading?
She saw my headshot up on the wall.
Let me see your headshot. Where is your headshot?
All right.
So, wait a minute. Everybody has to have headshots? Is that the deal?
Photos taken professionally, 8x10 photo.
Uh-huh.
And this is their calling card.
Oh, look, that's a good headshot.
And she was asking who my photographer was because she likes my headshots.
Wow. Had you ever had a headshot before?
I had one before, and it was in black and white, and now the industry wants it all in color.
Had you ever dabbled in show business? What was your other life all about?
I'm a retired deputy probation officer with Los Angeles County.
But you always had that hunger. Never had that hunger.
I retired almost 4 years ago and just started taking an acting class and just loved it.
And have you been bitten by the bug?
I have been bitten by the bug.
Are you waiting to be discovered?
I'm waiting to be discovered, yes.
And it could happen because this is what happens in Hollywood.
Yes, that's true. That's true. I consider this a glorified hobby, and I truly enjoy it. And if I get work, fine, and if I don't, I'm having a good time.
See, that's the benefit of being older as opposed to some of the newcomers starting off. This, whatever happens, it's a wonderful experience for you, right?
That's how I feel, yes.
We are the English contingent.
English contingent?
Yes, and we're playing in a show right now called Jack and Jill in Pantoland.
So these are real accents.
Oh, yes, of course.
Uh-huh.
Absolutely.
She's from, you know, and I'm the Cockney from the East End. You know, I talk like that. You know, I'm the tar lady. But I have to make a living, don't I? What can I do? What would you suggest,
Mr. Actress, let me tell you.
You all play well off each other, though.
Well, I'm from south of England, so I'm from the south with a hoity-toity royalty.
Oh, you're hoity-toity. You're the charwoman, and you're the upper crust.
No, yes. I'm the diva.
Yeah, you're on Masterpiece Theater.
No, I sing.
Oh. Yes, she does, Mr. Howser. And by the way, don't be worried about your accent, darling. Don't be worried about it. Look at us. Look what we have to live with all this time.
She's totally crazy.
Oh, I am.
Bonkers.
But you know what? I have a feeling you all might go places. Don't you?
From your mouth, darling, right up to God's ears, honest. Yes. We'd love to.
Why don't you come and see our show?
Well, I might.
Yeah, he's.
It's in your neck of the woods, Mr. Howser.
So you're already on stage?
Yes.
Oh, absolutely.
You're just not in front of the camera.
No, not quite. We strive every day to be on camera. You know, we can do everything. You name it, we can do it. We're just trying very hard.
Here she comes. Come on up. Your name is, oh boy, she's a live wire, all right.
You betcha. I'm renewing my career after many years of being away.
What do you mean? You've already been successful.
I was successful as a child. I got married for 52 years. My husband passed. We raised two wonderful children. I'm a great grandmother and a lot of energy, and I'm raring to go. And my whole new career is open to me, and I intend to succeed.
What did you do in the earlier days in the biz?
I sang, I danced, I did radio. We didn't have TV when I was working.
Yeah.
I did radio work, I did stage work.
And the whole time you were off raising your family,
yes.
Was it still in the back of your mind, or did you forget about it completely and
never,
think you'd never go back?
Never forgot about it. Knew someday I'd be right standing right here with you where
really?
I am.
Really?
Yes.
Now, have you been out on any auditions yet?
I just now got an agent a week ago, and she's raring to go, and so am I.
How hard was it to get an agent?
Three pictures to three agents. That's all it took.
Really?
And there I was. I had an agent, one of the finest agents.
Now, your expectations are realistic, though, aren't they?
Absolutely. I know I've got talent. I know I'm a terrific salesperson. I sold real estate, and I also taught salesmanship. And product is the main thing, and that's what I can sell.
But you've also got a good look. Now, there's the camera right there. Cameron, come right in on her face. I want you to sell yourself, not to me, but to the camera, to all those people sitting out there watching.
Well, to all of you people out there, never give up. Never give that dream away, because someday you get back to that dream, and it will happen.
Okay, what are we doing? We're learning our script.
We're learning the script, and we're filling out our registration form for the next semester.
Is this expensive? Is this free?
Unbelievably inexpensive.
Uh-huh.
It's $12 for a semester.
Wow.
And we probably have one of the best teachers in town. I go to two of his classes.
Now, you have a voice, like you could do voiceovers, or have you been in the business at all?
I was up to about 30 years ago and got back about 2.5 years ago.
What were you in, or what were you part of?
I was doing commercials at that time. And I've just done Gilmore Girls and The Flavor of Love, and I just did a student movie, but that's because of the fact that I just got an agent again. And I'm back with an agent.
How hard is it to get an agent today?
Very tough. There's fewer and fewer of them in the business, and they're very selective. And I went for about 2 months on interviews and finally got a call back with somebody who wanted me.
Now, is this fellow next to you a rookie, or?
No.
Do you remember the movie Rocky?
Yeah.
I wasn't in it.
No.
But I would have liked to have been.
Everybody here is just bursting with personality.
Yes, that's us.
I'm serious.
Yes, they're very comfortable doing what they're doing. I encourage them to be themselves,
blossom over time, or did they walk in here?
No, blossoms little by little. They feel comfortable, they grow. This is my friend Terry.
Terry came in
a little shy, sweet lady, a widow, and she has become the coffee lady of the class. She's become the social coordinator of the class.
Are you making commercials?
No, I'm making cookies.
Stand up here, fellas, for just a second. What role do you think you would be perfect for? If I had to describe you to people.
I've done already maybe a half a dozen ERs already, and I'm usually a patient at a Guernsey.
You're a patient on a gurney.
Yeah, right.
All right, now what's happening here, buddy?
We are going to read a copy, commercial copy.
Here's the copy up here.
Yes.
Here's your little camera right here.
Yes.
And they come up and stand right here. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Your name is?
Willa Reynolds.
And are you a little nervous about doing it in front of our camera, in front of your friends?
I'm not nervous about any of it.
Have you ever been nervous in your life?
Well, not... Yeah, probably, but in my earlier life, not in this later life. I am me.
See, that's wonderful.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Okay, so do we get everybody quiet?
Yeah, they understand. Okay. Okay, if I can have your attention, we're going to continue with the exercise, so I need you to be quiet. After Willa, we'll go through the list, beginning with 4, I believe. James, number 4, after Willa. Okay?
Oh, after Willa?
Okay, here we go. Willa. Your name again is?
I'm sorry?
Your name again?
Willa Reynolds.
Willa Reynolds.
Shelley, good to see you.
Okay, buddy, we're ready. Cameron, we can see Willa reading here.
And down, okay? Get quiet, please.
Willa Reynolds. When the kids move back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. Well, I called Public Storage and they sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies that we needed. Now, all of our extra belongings are in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there.
Okay, Willa, this time. Let's be softer, let's be nicer, let's be charming, let's be delightful, I got something to share with you, okay? I got a secret. The kids are coming home, okay? This is a secret, okay?
Take 2.
Willa Reynolds. When the kids moved back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. Well, I called the public storage, and they sent out the truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. Now, all of our extra belongings are in a safe and secure storage garage near our house. Maybe the kids could live there.
Very nice. Thank you, Willa.
Oh, that was nice.
Thank you.
And see, there was a difference in the way you had her read the same material.
Well, she did the work.
Wow.
Well, thank you.
Which one did you like the best?
The first one.
The kids are moving back again. What can I do? Public storage! Okay, so I want to see you happy. Happy, happy, okay?
You are a director, aren't you?
I am.
This is exciting. Let's look from here this time, Cameron.
Public storage is going to solve all your problems, Linda. What's your name?
Linda Vita. When the kids moved back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called the public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there.
Very nice, thank you.
You know, I just realized this is a great commercial for public storage too, isn't it?
When the kids move back home, I again knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called the public storage. They sent a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we need. All of our extra belongings are now in safe, secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there.
Give your best shot. Let's keep it charming, smiling, energetic. What's your name?
Eva Green. When the kids moved back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there too.
Okay, Eva, when you mentioned public storage,
yes,
that's the answer to your problems. We've got to hear, I called, bam, public storage. Okay? Give me the solution. I want to see it in your face. I want to hear your voice, okay?
Eva Green. When the kids moved back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there, too.
She added a word. Awesome. But I, you know, it needed a word at the end, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
Now, is there a certain copy that you feel better selling than others? I mean,
usually anything that have to do with food, I think I'm convincing because I really love food. Yeah. You know, so I can do that without having any difficulty.
So you didn't get real excited about public storage.
I sure didn't.
If we had been talking about a restaurant chain.
Absolutely.
Or a supermarket sale.
Yes.
This is your lady right here,
right?
Okay, Jerome, I want to try something different this time. You don't want the kids to come back, but they're coming back anyway. All right? Those darn kids are moving home again. I want to see grumpy. I want to see frustrated. I want to see how am I going to deal with this, okay? So it's a new spin on this, all right? But what is your answer?
Public storage.
Right, okay. Now at the end, what does that mean at the end? That means you're going to go right back to grumpy.
Right.
All right? Don't forget that. Okay, grumpy man, kids are coming home. What's your name?
Jerome Flyer. When the kids move back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving stuff we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there.
Okay, Jerome, not bad. I want you to go farther with it. Take it farther, okay? These damn kids are coming home again. Arr, give me anger.
Okay. Oh my God.
I had to call public storage, okay? Okay, give me anger, Jerome.
When the kids moved back home again, I knew that we had too much stuff in the house. I called public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving stuff we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our house. Maybe the kids could live there.
Oh, that was great. You're like a character actor, aren't you?
That's my idea. I'm a character actor.
Have you done acting before?
Yeah, some. Well, I'm in it now since I retired. Mm-hmm. And thanks to Buddy Powell, I'm getting expertise.
Uh-huh. Now, this is interesting. We're over here by the monitor because the two of you actually have been in a commercial.
That's right. I'm Roz.
I'm Elio.
Uh-huh. And what commercial is this?
Comcast High Internet Speeds, which is running now.
So you have a commercial running right now.
Yes, darling, of course.
Well, let's take a look at it, buddy.
You've heard of Fred and Ginger.
Oh, there they are. Where are you? Oh, look at this!
You go, girl.
Oh!
You go, girl.
How about that?
I've seen that commercial.
We see it all the time.
Rodeo, honey. Rodeo.
And guess
now
what?
Push that ceiling.
And guess what? We're getting residuals. My God.
And they're getting money.
So what does your family say when they see that?
Grandma, I saw you on TV.
Suddenly you have this whole new respect level.
It's a whole new life, honey.
It's unbelievable the effect it has on people that we know, not to speak about our families too. We are stars in their eyes. Worldwide, intercontinental,
what you know about me switching the tempo? Carolyn, what's your name?
Carolyn Iman. Those kids are moving back again. Then I knew we had too much stuff in the house. I called public storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in a safe and secure storage garage near our home. maybe the kids could live there too.
All right.
Yeah! All right! Oh! Oh! This is one of the best afternoons I've ever had in my life. You have an amazing class here.
Yes, they're incredible.
You're onto something, aren't
yes.
you?
Yes. Well, they're onto something. They're doing the work. They're pursuing it. They're attending class, and they're working on the projects, the exercises.
And isn't it amazing that I think there's this kind of potential almost in everybody, isn't there?
There is, and in every community.
Yeah.
There are seniors sitting at home watching television saying, I could be doing that.
Yeah.
And that's why we have these classes.
Yeah.
Get out of the television. Come to class.
And be off television.
And be on television.
Well, this is wonderful. We're going to put your name and the class.
Oh, thank you.
So people
thank
can,
you.
Although it looks like you're at
well,
capacity right
we
now.
We appreciate it. Thank
but
you.
But what you're doing is so much more important than just placing people on television in commercials. You are reawakening.
We're working on confidence. We're working on security.
Yeah.
We're working on individuality,
yeah.
bringing out personality.
And that's what life's all about.
Yeah, yeah.
At any age.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You,
this
Hugh.
Has
we
been absolutely
Thank
wonderful.
You.
Now, we've kind of agreed that we're not able to get everybody mm-hmm. on camera, but we wanted to give everybody their shot. So we're going to have a group read right here,
okay.
right now. This
okay.
is where we're going to end it.
Okay.
We've had a wonderful afternoon. Thanks, buddy.
Let's slate our name. Slate your name and get into it.
Well, to all of you people out there, never give up. Never give that dream away, because someday you get back to that dream and it will happen.
When the kids moved back home again, I knew we had too much stuff in the house. I called Public Storage. They sent out a truck, boxes, and all the moving supplies we needed. All of our extra belongings are now in the safe, secure garage, storage garage near our home. Maybe the kids could live there.
Visiting with Huell Howser is made possible through a generous grant from the Ralph M. Parsons Foundation.